Hi, my name is Jose David Corona, but people normally call me JD for short. After obtaining my bachelor's degree from UTSA, I transferred back home to the Valley and went straight into my master's degree. So I don't have a lot of experience being a teacher, but I did do my observation hours and my student teaching at a school during my time at UTSA. I learned a lot during my observations and especially during my student teaching experience when I had to actually become a teacher. Have you ever been in a class and before you dive into the lesson, your teacher has you go over vocabulary words, their definitions, and even key concepts? If you have, this is called pre-training. In this video, we will go over what pre-training is and how effective it is not only in the classroom, but in other workplaces as well. So, what is pre-training? Pre-training is when you learn key terms and concepts before going into the main lesson. In simpler terms, pre-training is a mini lesson over key ideas and sometimes vocabulary words and their definitions before the actual lesson. What this does is that it allows for students or new trainees to get an idea and a better understanding of what the main lesson is about. By doing this, students and new trainees are able to process the information from the main lesson better. And they will not be struggling over a vocabulary word or a concept that they did not know before the pre-training. An example of pre-training in the classroom is when the teacher gives the students an activity to do before the lesson, such as one where the students have to match the vocabulary words to the correct definitions, or by having the students play a game on Blookit or some other kind of online game for students. By doing this, the students will understand terms and ideas that they would not have known before the pre-training. An example of pre-training in the workplace could be when someone is working at a place where they have to use machinery, and the trainees are given a guide on how the different machines work in the workplace and the purpose of each one. By doing this, the trainees will have a better understanding of how the machines work and they will not be lost the next time they have to use them. It is important to note that pre-training can be used in just about anything and anywhere where there is going to be a main lesson taught. In conclusion, the use of pre-training in the classroom and workplaces is a very useful tool that should be used more often. Students and trainees will be able to take in the information from the actual lesson better, and with less trouble than they would without pre-training. Thank you for your time, and I hope you enjoyed learning about pre-training.